Every time I drill a hole in the roof, I get a terrible feeling that I shouldn't be drilling a hole in the roof. Having a van means that lots of cables need to go through into the van. I've found this product, rather than the normal cable gland thing that goes on the roof with umpteen amounts of Sikaflex. It is IP66 rated, which means it's waterproof, it is dustproof, and I'm thinking of putting that on the roof with this one big hole going through the roof, and if I ever need cables, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here's 2 on this side, that's where the solar panels will go. I can put lights, I can put cameras, and I can put action. I don't know, anything else I want to put in there. If I open this up, I'm hoping that fits in there nicely. Sikaflex in there, let it set, and then hopefully I just need to drill one large hole and future-proof drilling any more holes. That's the plan. What do you think? Do you think it's mad? At least if I get a leak, I know it's coming from one hole. But I have heard that when you drill a hole, the drip may not show up where the actual leak is, because it runs along the roof and then starts dripping at the lowest point. At least if I have one hole, I know I need to check just this. So I'm going to drill this now, put Tiger Seal on there, tighten it up, and leave it to set over the weekend. Then we got to drill a hole into the roof when this is ready, tighten it from below, and it should hopefully be entirely sealed. Now, if I can just find the right size hole, I think it's a little bit large. There's a hole in the center there. I'm just going to take it slowly. It's a little bit blunt. I'm just smoothing off where I cut. There's 4 screw sections that are here that need to be ground down so that that fits flush. I'm not so worried about underneath because the Sikaflex will form over there. This will get pushed against the roof and the Sikaflex won't get squeezed out. And you actually need some Sikaflex there not squeezed out to form the seal. Okay, so that's done. That fits very nicely in there. Now I'm just going to rough up around the hole so that the Sikaflex has something to stick to. I want to have a clean edge. When I put this on the roof, I want to put a fresh thing of Sikaflex. In order to get a clean section, I'm going to put this blue tape and just cut around the center. It will also help center the item. Perfect. Now, I'm going to take a number of pieces and again, I should put this in place. Put some blue tape at the top, the bottom. Side and then the other side, and then I'll go into the corners. And I'm just going to keep adding until I'm happy with the neatness. You can see I can now put the Sikaflex there, put this in, and we should be okay. However, I'm going to see if I can clamp up to this wood. And yes, I can. I don't need it to be tight, I just want it to be held in place without being bumped. going to use Tiger Seal again because I got left over. I'm not going to use Sikaflex. What I normally do now is just take a piece of wood and just smear it and make sure that it's actually adhering, and then just go around making sure that it's as level as possible. Okay, then I'm going to put this in slowly. Then I'm going to put this on, and then I'm going to tighten this. And that's as tight as I'm going. I'm not going to go any tighter, but I just want to move it about. And that's it. I'm going to let that sit for half an hour, and then I will clean up the edges by taking off this tape. And then use some olive oil just to smooth it over, make it neat. So that's my idea, one hole. What do you think? Do you think I'm a little bit mad, or do you think I'm onto something? Please let me know in the comments. My videos have been a little bit backlogged because I don't have electricity in the van at the moment. So I'm hopefully going to get this video out just to get your feedback. Should I drill a hole or should I not? And then hopefully I can move on and get the solar panels installed and get electricity in the van and start catching up on the editing. So I will be back. Everything's good with me. I'm doing some odd jobs around, so I'm good. I'm happy. I'm living in the van now full time. I'm no longer in bricks and mortar, but I'm enjoying it, even though I don't have electricity. But please, if you like this video, hit the like, consider subscribing, keep well, keep safe, and keep camping. Thanks very much.